His father played here, Greg. He wears number 12, the same number his daddy wore. And when I actually coached here, he used to run out of the dressing room in a diaper. Ryan Malone was born to be a Penguin.
Pittsburgh, you know, Ron Francis, I think, was my favorite player. I liked kind of everything about him, the way he played. And Mario was a big influence just on the game in general.
The Penguins have won the Stanley Cup!
Here I am, this is me. There's nowhere else on earth I'd rather be.
I was counting down the last couple of days of training camp, and I know they only had a couple of guys left, so I was on the bubble, but ended up being in the lineup for the opening night, and that was a dream come true. I never ever thought we'd be pulling over a Penguin sweater.
Okay, Mr. GM, he's an unrestricted free agent at the end of the year. Are you going after him, and what's the cost?
Well, the cost is going to be a pretty penny, no question about it. In this day and age, a 25-goal scorer, what's he worth? $2.5 to $3 million, maybe more, as an unrestricted free agent. But the funny thing is, you know, I played my whole career in my hometown. I'm wondering if he'd be better off somewhere else. He certainly needs a fighting lesson from his buddy George LaRocque in this one, but give him points for jumping in. No question, he's a valuable commodity. A lot of teams will be suited.
This is a career right now, a career year for Ryan Malone, and I think the biggest thing about it is because he senses that unrestricted free agent.
Young Penguin, Ryan Malone is showing a lot of maturity these days, and he's a new dad to boot. Albie Oxenrider talked with Ryan one-on-one.
As the team has risen, you've also risen. I mean, there was a time not too long ago when you were wondering, was there a place for you here? Or could you be a part of this? And you have actually taken your game to the next level. I mean, how satisfying is that for you personally, Ryan?
I mean, it's good. I think, you know, as a hockey player, you're always sort of striving to get better and kind of take your game to different levels. And, you know, I still think I have a little more to go. I think I am, you know, playing some good hockey right now. But, you know, playing with Gino and Sid, you know, it's pretty easy to play with those guys. So, you know, I think, you know, just try to get ready on and off the ice for, you know, a certain amount of stretch games here, and hopefully everything works out.
How is life as a dad? And I guess it's good in a way that those early days got out of the way before the playoff run starts.
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, fatherhood, honestly, was just a miracle. I can't really describe it. Your heart just melts for the little guy right there on the spot. And, you know, it was just a miracle. My wife is doing a great job here. And, you know, I wouldn't be here, you know, right now at this point in the season without, you know, my family.
Do you find because of your new son and because of the way the team is going right now, playoffs coming on, I mean, this is an incredibly exciting time for you.
Yeah, I keep bringing Will to the big games. He's been to like 4 games and we're 4-0, so knock on wood. So he's our good luck charm. But yeah, I think it's exciting for me and my family and, you know, for the team. I think some of the guys, you know, that not too many of, you know, Sid doesn't have too many friends that are having babies yet. So it's kind of his first, you know, buddy that had a kid. So it's kind of nice to see.
You better get your son some playoff tickets.
Yeah, definitely.
You think this team is right where it needs to be with the playoffs really right around the corner?
I think we're close. I still think, you know, we can play better. The full 60 minutes. Sometimes, you know, if we get up, you know, 3-4 goals, you do kind of get a little lackadaisical. But, you know, we're a young team and we're going to learn from our mistakes. And I think that's the biggest thing. We don't seem to be repeating ourselves too often.
Sky's the limit?
Sky's the limit.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's sellout crowd is the Penguins' 35th sellout of the year at Mellon Arena, representing a new single-season Penguins franchise record. It is also the 48th consecutive regular season sellout dating back to last season. On behalf of the Penguins players and coaches, Pittsburgh's own Ryan Malone would like to say a few words.
On behalf of the team, we'd like to thank all the fans and season ticket holders for your support. Being from Pittsburgh, I know how loyal all you fans can be. So thank you very much. Let's win this thing.